Let's study about space wave propagation. We have discussed that up to 30 MHz frequencies which are reflected by ionospheric layers, sky waves are used for propagation. And here we can write electromagnetic waves of frequency range above 40 MHz are used for space wave propagation, which are not reflected by ionospheric layers. But here another important point which is very useful to know is that for space wave propagation, in which line of sight communication is done. Or you can say here, line of sight must be clear for transmission and reception antennas, as such high frequency waves are not obstructed by ground waves or sky wave propagation, but obstructed by physical objects if line of sight is obstructed. Like say if we are having a transmitting antenna and there is a receiving antenna, and if there is a line of sight between the two, proper communication of signals at frequencies above 40 MHz will be done. But if there is a building between the two, in this situation as line of sight is not there, the communication will be obstructed and no signal can be transmitted, because at such high frequency the power is transmitted in a specific direction, and this will be almost you can say a rectilinear propagation. Diffraction effects are almost negligible at such high frequencies, so communication cannot be done if line of sight is not there. If we talk about the earth curvature, then we can say if there is a transmitting antenna which is having a height HT. Generally these antennas are kept at higher altitude so that earth's curvature can be accounted and the signals can be transmitted to another region where you can say a receiving antenna is placed of height HR. This is a transmitting antenna and this is the receiving antenna. And Earth's curvature is tangentially taken care by the line of sight communication between the transmission and receiving antenna. So this is the distance which we can consider as the range of this communication system for space waves. And this dr can be considered as sum of dt and drx, which is the distance of tangential point from the transmitting antenna to the distance of tangential point up to the receiving antenna. Here if Earth is considered to be a sphere of radius r, then in this situation we can easily calculate the value of dtx, which can be written as this dtx we can write as the root of this is ht plus r whole square minus r square. On simplifying we'll be getting it root of twice of htr, as here we can write ht is very less compared to the radius of Earth. Similarly, drx, the distance of a tangential point of Earth from line of sight to the receiving antenna, can be directly written as twice of 2hrr. Now, in this situation, if we talk about the range of a space wave propagation is, it depends on the height of antenna, which can be written as dr, which will be dtx plus drx, which is equals to root of 2htr plus root of 2hrr. This will be the range of space wave communication system if height of transmitting antenna is ht and height of receiving antenna is hr. And if line of sight is adjusted such that at one point it is almost tangential to the Earth's surface, but even at this tangent, it is considered to be slightly above the population density on the Earth's surface so that the line of sight will not be hindered.